I have titty sweat and no titties. I don't know who's on the weather machine, but why does it have to rain every Sunday? Lay off, take a break. I know y'all sick of seeing me with my hair up in a claw clip, but between the rain and the heat, baby, that's all I got in me. I look good, I smell good, I drive good.
Don't look at me, sir. Don't come over here and bother me.
Who was wondering? Yeah, boy, I'm still at it. Bitch, I had to block you, but you still gotta watch this shit. Cause who the fuck rocking like me? No bra, tight tee, slick back, ponytail, feeling like I'm iced tea.
It's a whole lot of money in this motherfucker. Can't wear the shit you bitches wear because it's cheap to me. It's some money at my table, grab a seat for me. Cost a ticket just to cover all my legal fees. I don't hang with jealous bitches, that's a weak disease. Hold on, run up. If you're broken in my business, then just shut up. I invested in my body, bitch, I'm done up. I look good, I like to fuck on when the sun up. Put on my jewelry just to go to the bodega. And I keep it with me just so that I'm feeling safer.
I made it. At least I'm in the park. It's inside the park in Williamsburg. So now I gotta walk over to the trucks. And it's a little confusing. Make sure you read the sign when you're trying to find the eats. I did not feel like going walking back around so I could get to the tables. I hate walking in grass and it's wet, but like I'm definitely not walking around this mat. Yo, it is so hot and all the tables don't have umbrellas and that's pissing me off. Wow. I just had that empanada, it was really good. Now I'm sitting here waiting for my sister because y'all know I'm always the early one. It's not OD late. We said we was gonna come here at 12. I think it's like 12:15, 12:20, but who knows if she left or not. I'm telling all her business. But I needed to get something because I was really hungry and I couldn't decide on like what my meal was gonna be. That's why I got the empanada. Yesterday I had literally just a bacon and egg and cheese on a bagel like the whole day. I ate half in the morning and then ate half in the afternoon and then I wasn't really that hungry. Yeah, I'm gonna wait. I'm probably gonna look on a website to see like different people food options. I don't feel like walking back over there. It's so hot. The sun went down, but there's no umbrellas at half of the tables. Only like, I would say like five. Yeah, like five tables have umbrellas. And I keep seeing people with these drinks that are in watermelons, but I don't know if it's just like a fresh juice in a watermelon, in a pineapple, or if it's like an alcoholic beverage. I kind of want a cocktail, but like I don't want to pass out. It's so hot. I'm gonna finish my peach lemonade. This was really good. And it had actual chunks of peach inside, which I didn't expect looking at it, but it's really good. It's just that the ice in it was like pretty much melted when I got it. Don't look at me, sir. Don't come over here and bother me. Anyway, let me finish, wait for my sister. And maybe she can help me decide what I wanna eat, cause I don't know, there's so many options. I usually always have a claw clip, and today I chose not to bring one with me. But I'm definitely not staying out here alone. Oh my God, the space is way too open. Let me stop complaining.
Hey yo, I put on my jewelry just to suck my nigga off. Fingers on his balls like I'm about to tell him cough. Wait, how long? Can't give it to him dry like that. You gotta get that shit wet first. You gotta prep them for shit like that. Bring that shit back. Bring that shit the fuck back. I put on my jewelry just to go up by the pool. And I keep it with me.
It's too hot. It's just sun on skin. There's. Wow. What is going on? I have titty sweat and no titties.
I'ma make these niggas drool. Higher than the moon, but I'm in tune. So don't run up, cause if you run up, I guarantee you ain't gon' leave with the gun up. Some little Chinese bangs with the bun up. I got the crown low, but you just gon' run up.
Put on my jewelry just to go to the bodega. And I keep it with me just so that I'm feeling safer. Fendi on my body, but my feet is in bodega. Bitch, I'm getting money, give a fuck about it.
Ooh, you got a coconut. Yo, ever since.
I'm gonna eat that shit.
What does that mean? No, I don't any.
Like jelly.
Oh. Yo, ever since you said that coconut water tastes like you put it in your mouth and went.
I don't like it though. I never used to like it.
I'd be crying. Go ahead, drink your coconut. How is it? Is it cold?
Hey, yo, Bia. I just bent the block. Well, these bitches wanna be ya. Probably cause my waist gone many long year. Well, I ain't talking cars, going here, don't Kia. In a twin seater, you Tamara, Miss Tia. My pussy pitsy, I fuck them like porn stars. Ooh. I'm playing basketball, but my bitches is all stars. Got Richie on my wrist cause I'm richer than most broads. Yeah, make these bitches poop and they're sending my postcard.
Put on my jewelry just to go to the bodega. And I keep it with me just so that I'm feeling safer. Fendi on my body, but my feet is in bodega. Bitch, I'm getting money, give a fuck about a hater.
Alright, let's go. Hey y'all. It's many hours later, and that heat took me out so bad. I met up with my sister, we had some food and stuff at Smorgasburg, and after that, she had to go about her business. I had to go get some flowers because I'm going out later again for someone's birthday. And literally I walked back home from the flower market and I felt like I was going to pass out. It was definitely giving heat exhaustion, so I literally came straight home, took up all my clothes, got up under the AC and took a nap. The sun drained me of energy, so I'm showering. Girl, I took a shower and I feel so much better. Like, you could probably even tell my energy is different now. Like, I feel not gross. This is my second shower of the day for the past, I want to say, like, 2 or 3 weekends. I've been showering, like, 3 times, like, every weekend, because that's the only time I really go outside, for real, for real. But anyway, I'm showered, I'm moisturized. And I'm about to do my makeup real quick. My hair, claw clipping it. I'm so happy claw clips came back in style, because styling in the heat, dub. Dub. Big dub. Right now, I'm about to turn on some music and do my skin. I mean, not my skincare. Do my makeup and get out of here. Hopefully in like 40, 45 minutes. So, TTYL, babes. Now I did my nails and one fell off already.
Flowers and candy, the simple things. In addition to the SLs, we get some rain.
I woke up this morning. Oh. I'ma take you 10 miles and I buy you, baby. Show you how I put down what buys you, baby. I'm your one diamond girl. You're the reason I put the game for.
Girl, you taste like a Cinnabon.
Don't creep from the side to the feet.
Text on the beat,
text the size of my beat. Look up, ran out of look up.
Trying to reach
up, get a look up.
Who gives a fuck?
Thank you, girl.
Who, me?
What you mean?
I am back. I feel so much better. I feel clean. I got my hair up because I'm just over everything. I'm over the heat. specifically. I think we're going to do a little quick fit check. I'm gonna try to take a picture before I leave. I have to go to LES, love it there. I'm probably gonna take an Uber. It's only like 20 minutes away, not bad. My teeth look so white. Shout out to the Crest whitening strips because my teeth is giving glamorous whites. I love that for me. But yes, let's do a quick little fit check and then I'm gonna try to take a picture and be out. Keeping it calm but cute. So I have on this Amazon bodysuit. It's supposed to be a Skims dupe, I believe, but I don't have the Skims version, so I can't confirm or deny that. I just need another black bodysuit that was not my Wolford one. I have on these Norma Kamali spat leggings. They have like a little slingy. I'm about to fall over, child. They have like a little slingy situation here. And I love these leggings. I bought them with the intention of just being able to throw on with the bodysuit when I don't really feel like thinking of an outfit. Today was one of them days. Actually, every weekend is one of them days. But anyway, bag is from a brand called Aqua from Bloomingdale's. I believe that brand is only at Bloomingdale's. It might be a Bloomingdale's in-house brand, like they store brand. And then I have on these thong sandals from Nine West. And they are low-key kitten heels. I ain't gonna hold you. But you can't really tell because I have on longer pants. But yeah, these are only like 2.75 inches. It's definitely under 3. Simple, cute, but it's still giving like she's her. Let me flip y'all around real quick for jewelry. I have on a Amazon tennis necklace that I just bought. These earrings, I honestly don't remember where I got them from, but they're just basic ass hoops. And I have on matching tennis bracelet from Amazon. So there we have it. Today's scent of the night is Balenciaga Flora Botanica. I'm gonna put the notes on the screen and probably link it in the description. I like this perfume a lot. It gives very like sultry, sexy, going out and about vibe. So this is what she's wearing today. I know y'all sick of seeing me with my hair up in a claw clip, but between the rain and the heat, baby, that's all I got in me. That is all I got in me. I will not waste my time curling my hair one more day, straightening my hair one more day just for it to get fucked up because of the weather. We not doing that. Me not deal with that, nah. Anyway, I'm out. Okay, bye. These are the flowers that I put together. I think I did a pretty good job. I could be a tough critic on myself. I think they came out cute. I don't know if I should put it in the brown paper though. I might. Yeah, I am. I like pre-rolled the paper. But let me hurry up. My Uber's coming. Good morning. It is Sunday, about like 11:30. And let me just tell you about my Saturday real quick. My Saturday was cute. It was chill. It was just what I needed. I want to say that one weekend when I was outside took me out, but like low-key, I'm good with the calm vibes. So yesterday I went to a homegirl of mine's birthday party. It was like an intimate birthday party and it was really cute. Loved it. Loved that. Happy birthday again, Jamie. I hope you really enjoyed your birthday and more blessings and prayers and all that good stuff goes out to you. After that, I went to go grab food from 7th Street Burgers. I always see them and it always be lines outside. I'm just like, okay, this gotta be a good ass burger because like, why is everybody always outside this spot? Anyway, I went there. It was no line. So I was like, oh, let me get some food. I got a burger, a regular cheeseburger, and some french fries. And it wasn't bad, but it just wasn't what I set my expectations on. One, the burger was mad small. It was mad small. It was given like the size of a White Castle burger, but like a little smidge bigger. I didn't need a big ass burger, but it was just like, damn. Okay. The french fries were good. They were like crunchy fries, but they were a little bit salty to me. They have like a house sauce, was really good. So they put the house sauce on the burger, but then I got a house sauce on the side that was spicy. That was good because the house sauce has like a sweet taste to it. So with the spice, I was like, yeah, this is doing it for me. Other than that, child, I came home. My friends were going to Rogers Garden, but by the time I got home and ate, my friend called me. It was like 1:15. I'm like, yeah, I'm not going anywhere. Rogers Garden closed at 2:00. All I'm gonna do is end up at Rogers Garden for 30 minutes and then end up, I don't know, doing whatever just to kill time and get back at 5:00 in the morning. And then I just knew I had things to do today and I just wanted to be relaxed and not anxious. So on the agenda for today, I'm about to go edit some content, do a little light planning of my week. Other than that, I have a driving lesson later today and my friends invited me over for dinner, so I'll probably pull up on them and see what's up. Another thing, it is raining again. I don't know who's on the weather machine, but why does it have to rain every Sunday? Summertime Sunday is not giving rain every week. It's getting crazy. Lay off, take a break. Now that I said my piece, I'm gonna talk to y'all later and do what I gotta do. Bye. Guess who's back? It's me. Currently cleaning a stain off of my t-shirt. I done got makeup on and I'm not even wearing makeup. I was touching something. Haven't even made it out the house. Anyway, let me turn off the fan real quick because I know that is annoying. I got some editing done. When I told y'all, editing for YouTube is no joke, so you really got to give the YouTube girlies their things, whether they new vets or whatever. If you join YouTube at any level, I tip my Von Dutch hat to you. I'm about to go to the corner store, get me probably, I'm gonna get me a salad from the corner store. Then I have to head across town. I have another driving lesson. Then I'm gonna hit Quam and see what the boys is doing. They said they was making dinner. We'll see. I just wanted to check in real quick. So I'm Aggie because I have to change my shirt. I blow dried it, but I think shout wipes are intended for you to shot it out real quick and still have to clean it because it went like left like a wet spot, which I'm sure is from it being like, I don't know, not detergent, but not detergent, if that makes sense. Oh, this got me mad. I need more white tees. I don't have no more plain white tees. That's going below my, but I just wanted to say, if you're gonna use a shout wipe to take out a stain, just be mindful that it may have a temporary stain. What I think at least would be a temporary stain. Hello, good, how are you? Can I have a salad, regular lettuce, but I want the halal chicken in the salad. Yeah, carrots, cucumber, black olives. What is this, cranberries? Yeah, cranberries, red onion. This is only nuts?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take those then. And then I'll do regular tomato and cheese. And for my dressing, I'll do Caesar. Dressing Caesar. I don't know if everybody corner store sell salads, but mine do, and it be hitting. You just gotta make sure you get the halal chicken, the same chicken that they use for chicken over rice. It is so good. I also got this brand, Hulls, I guess, seltzer water. If you watch my, I think, very first vlog, you probably see me drink the ginger ale, but I think they're most known for their seltzer water, which I love. I usually get mango, but they didn't have mango, so we gonna have to do fruit punch, which is my second favorite. So let me eat because I gotta hurry up and go on the other side of Brooklyn. Hey y'all, I'm back home and I'm so tired. I did my driving lesson, chill with my mom and the pets for a bit, and now I'm back in the house and I'm about to eat the rest of my salad that I had earlier. But yeah, I'm just really tired, so I'm just gonna call it a day for real, and just chill, probably watch Insecure or something on TV. Honestly, this is gonna be the last time y'all talk to me today. I'll holla at you in the morning because I'm very tired. I can barely talk, like, I just feel, I need to sleep for like 2 weeks, but I'm out. Good morning, y'all. It is Monday morning and I feel refreshed. I went to bed so early yesterday. I think by like 9:30, I was probably knocked out. I was in bed watching Insecure and I'm very happy I did that. I woke up around 5. I felt great. I didn't feel groggy or anything. Showered, moisturized my body. Now I'm about to get ready for the day. Today, I am actually taking my driver's exam. And this is my second time around. I took it like 5 years ago when I was, I guess I could say, young and dumb. And this time around, I feel much more confident in my abilities to pass, even if I do make small mistakes. It's about 6:30. I have to be to the driving school at 8 o'clock, and then they're gonna take me to my road test, which is at 9 a.m. And I'm just gonna get myself together. I'm gonna do a little light beat, throw in some comfortable clothes, probably grab me something to eat from the corner store. And then after that, I'm gonna head on the opposite side of Brooklyn and we're gonna do our driving test. We're gonna pass. We're gonna feel like the last 6 months that we've been working so hard to master our driving skills is gonna come into play at this very moment. Now I'm gonna finish getting ready. Okay, bye. It's me again. I am dressed. I just have on a Aritzia bodysuit. I'm not going to do a fit check. I'm going to tell y'all what I have on. I have on a Aritzia Wilfit Free Kick Flare or something bodysuit. Very comfortable. I just want to be comfortable. As you can see, I did my makeup. I just did, like, you know, some coverage just to make me feel like that girl. I smell good. I have on Valentino Voce Viva. And I keep telling myself I look good, I smell good, I drive good, and I got this. My driving school just called me and told me that they're ready for me to pull up to be there by 8 a.m., excuse me. And just to make sure I have my glasses. Well, I wear contacts, but I'm bringing my glasses just in case somebody try to act stupid. I'm gonna bring an extra pair of contacts too. Other than that, I made sure I packed my bag with my permits. And yeah, after I eat this boiled egg, because I decided not to go to the corner store, I don't want anything heavy or greasy on my stomach, I'm just gonna eat a boiled egg, drink some water, and call it a day. After I do that, I'm gonna throw on my shoes and leave out the house and head on the other side of Brooklyn. So yes, wish me luck, y'all. It was nice hearing from my driver school and, you know, them just like running through a list of things. And it didn't make me nervous at all. It was just like someone's calling me in the morning to remind me of a meeting later. So that made me feel good. But yeah, I still don't feel jittery. But of course, I won't know fully until I get to the drive-in road test. But yeah, let me go eat so I can be out later, y'all. Made it to the driving site and I still feel pretty good. Everybody I've interacted with this morning has been pretty pleasant. The person who called me, the person who took me to the driving site, and the person who I think is the owner who also called me. But anyway, yeah, everybody has been like sending me good praises. My stepmom texted me and was like, congratulations in advance. So yeah, it's about 8:30. My appointment is into 9 o'clock. I already told my manager at work that I'm taking my road test today, so I'll be online whenever I get back home. So yeah, I'm just gonna chill here. I might listen to a little bit more gospel. I love Brighter Day by Kirk Franklin. That's like my favorite power up song. So yeah, I'm about to do that. I'm probably putting on some lip gloss because I keep telling myself I look good, I smell good, I drive good, and that's what's gonna get me through. I'm not gonna put pressure on myself. Okay, bye. Hey y'all, I'm back from my road test and I have no idea how I did. Okay, let me not say that. I feel like I did really well. I wasn't really anxious when I started. I made like very small mistakes that should not make me fail. This time around, the examiner was really polite, which made me feel so much better. The lady checking you in, she was so nice. She was so nice and she complimented my makeup not once, but twice, and that made me feel good. It put me in a good mood because I do notice my driving changes based on the energy of the person in the passenger seat, specifically when I don't know the person, like, you know. So apparently they don't give you your exam results right away because I guess people be turning up at the testing sites when they get failed or whatever. I'm pretty confident that I did pass. On top of me just like parallel parking perfectly, my K-turn slash broken U-turn perfect. Yeah, I didn't do any excessive maneuvers. It was like small things. I was like, damn, you know, whatever. But like still things that wouldn't give me a ton of points off. I'd be trying to read between the lines, you know, because when we finished and I had to pull over and let the examiner out and then wait for my driving school instructor to come back, he was like, you can relax now. I was like, I can't relax. It's 6 p.m. And then he said it will be official at 6 p.m. I feel like he wouldn't have said that if, you know, I didn't pass, because like, who wants to officially fail? I'm gonna try not to think about it. Literally on the way home, I checked the website like 5 times and there's still no results. But I totally get why they don't give you the results up front before. I mean, anymore. But now it's literally just like they give you a card with the website information and you gotta look it up. It says after 6 p.m. I believe on the back of the card. I was like, that's so annoying. Like, the anxious girl is like me. We can't say that. But I went to the corner store and I got myself a bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel. I did, even though I'm supposed to be on a little diet. But yeah, I'm about to eat and get to work. Yeah, I have a lot of work to do as per usual. I don't have a lot to do, but I have a lot that I want to get done because I have some personal stuff, like some, I guess, creative projects that I'm working on top of like me having to do like my other work. And I have like just errands and shit I probably need to run. But I'm supposed to see y'all later. I'm getting hot. I'm turning on the AC. Holla at y'all. The results are finally in after many hours. I passed! I passed my test. Woo! I've been waiting all day to say that. Wow, let me just take a breather. I'm getting all anxious even though like I got the results. Hold on one second. Like, I knew I passed, but until it was in writing, it was just like, I don't know if I really passed. I did phenomenal, as I thought. Everything was perfect except he said I turned, I think, wide right and then a little short left, but like I ain't hit nothing. I still turn. And I feel like regardless, like those are things you perfect over time, and that was like 10 points. The maximum you could get off on a New York State road test is 30. After 30 points, you fail. So I'm so happy. I am Mika, the licensed driver. Talk to me nice. I can't wait. Oh, when my license come in the mail, yo, I'm already preparing to run away. Like, oh, now I can really start finding a car. Like, I already been saving for a car, but just like a little bit of money because I'm also moving, so I'm saving to move as well. So I'm just so happy because it's like I always imagine myself driving, but like after failing my road test 5 years ago, I was just so discouraged and kind of convinced myself that I didn't need to drive, that I was going to be rich and have a chauffeur or have my man drive me, and I was going to be a passenger princess. But quite frankly, the type of person I am, I'm very independent, so it didn't make sense for me to never drive. Like, it just wasn't realistic. But now I'm so happy. I'm so f-ing happy. And on top of like being happy that I passed, like, I'm just so proud of myself for how much like I really put in the work these past 6 months to not only drive and learn so I can pass the road test, but also to learn like how important it is to be a safe driver, because like driving is a real responsibility outside of the financial aspect, as far as like how much it costs to buy a car, gas a car, insure a car, and all that good stuff. You're putting your life and other people's lives at stake, and I don't take that lightly. With that said, I must have finished this article I gotta submit for work. After that, we get a lemon drop. I'm okay with making a cocktail at home, but if somebody's trying to lean for a little Vibiana, I'm down. It's still hot and muggy. Let me finish my day. Lemon drop or something after. It's lit. Your girl is a licensed driver. Talk to me nice.